Les Misérables is an 1862 novel by the great French writer Victor Hugo. One of the longest of all the classics, it's a mixture of epic storyline and social commentary. Roughly a quarter of the novel consists of Victor Hugo's own musings on topics such as architecture, philosophy, and love. The author describes the story as a progress from evil to good, from injustice to justice, from falsehood to truth, from non-existence to God. It's a snapshot of a society at a particular time, France between the Battle of Waterloo and the Paris insurrections of 1832. There are four protagonists, the main one being Jean Valjean. Valjean is an ex-convict who begins as a villain but reforms after a priest shows him kindness. He becomes the most noble of all the book's characters. Secondly, there's the police inspector Javert, who suspects Valjean of wrongdoing virtually from the outset and who pursues him with a supernatural determination. Thirdly, there's Cosette, the girl whose mother died as a result of exploitation and disease and who Valjean brings up out of kindness and a sense of charitable duty. And finally, there's Marius, a young man who falls in love with Cosette and finds his love reciprocated. In many ways, it's Inspector Javert's pursuit of Jean Valjean that provides the novel's narrative drive. It's tempting to describe Cosette and Marius' stories as a subplot, but of course, everything's intertwined here, including the authorial commentary. There's no doubt that Les Misérables is well worth the reading time. It engages every emotion at some point, often intensely, and of course, it's thought-provoking. It's also a window into a specific historical period. In 1853, Napoleon III began to rebuild Paris in what he considered to be a more prestigious style. He embarked on a programme of slum clearance combined with the construction of spacious boulevards, imposing buildings and public fountains. Hugo, however, was deeply attached to the old Paris. His 1831 The Hunchback of Notre Dame was really an attempt to save the cathedral, and it succeeded. When Les Misérables was published, the city he loved was on its way out, but I'd imagine he thought it was merely getting a facelift. Les Misérables underlines the fact that gentrification does nothing to solve a community's deepest social problems. And a lot of that underlining happens because of Hugo's own running commentary on his own story. It's much more than an historical novel. Hugo wrote of Les Misérables, wherever men go in ignorance or despair, wherever women sell themselves for bread, wherever children lack a book to learn from or a warm hearth, Les Misérables knocks at the door. It's a bold claim, but one that's probably stood the test of time.